An announcer, after a hard and long day at the studio, admitted he had other things on his mind when it came time for doing this commercial for a beauty salon.
Ladies, when it's time for a trip to the beauty parlor, remember it's Helen's on 5th and Main Street. Helen's has the reputation for being the town's finest beauty saloon.
Our next recording is dedicated to Rosemary Bates, who is getting married tonight. We hear now, It Only Hurts for a Little While.
Let's tune in on your comparative shopper of the air.
Our price survey, made at the various local department stores here in town, shows very little change in prices. Our survey shows that the only items pertain to ladies' dresses and men's pants. Ladies' dresses are going up, and men's trousers are going down all over town.
And now back to our all-request recorded program. We've had a request for a record by that popular Irish tenor, Mary Olanza.
Oh, did you see today's Wall Street Journal trying to cheer itself up? Reports on the lady who was shopping for a frilly nightgown as a birthday present for her pet poodle. They didn't have any, but the store clerk said, if you'll measure the dog, we'll have one made. And the lady said, oh, I couldn't do that. I want it to be a surprise. Page 2.
One of the most spectacular kinds of automobile accidents is the one in which a car not only gets banged up, but bursts into flames. What makes it really horrible is the idea that a driver and his passengers, stunned by the accident, may be trapped inside the burning car. The National Safety Council says that, fortunately for most of us, this type of spectacular smash-up is very rare. Only one driver... Good night, Mother. The thing that stuns people inside a car... well, someday it just doesn't make it up.
Here's a news item that was handed to a newscaster without it being checked in advance.
And in the head-on collision of the two passenger cars, 5 people were killed in the crash. 2 seriously.
Attention, young ladies. Attention, young ladies. Your country needs your services. Hospitals throughout the nation are greatly understaffed. Nurses are urgently needed. Volunteer to be one of America's white-clapped ladies of mercy.
We take you now to Minneapolis and hear the MC of a program known as Polka Dance Party.
Well, radio audience, this is a sad day for this program. Alice Dale, who has been mistress of ceremonies on this show with me, is leaving after 5 years. The producers of this program and the sponsors have decided that her replacement will come from the ranks of our loyal radio listeners. All you talented ladies who feel that you can do the job can apply. So ladies, if you want to be my mistress, call Newton 20161.
We now take you to the 50-yard line, where a Big Ten football game is in progress.
The center snaps the ball back. It's Peters on a handoff from the quarterback. He cuts off tackle. He's down to the 30, the 20, the 10, and he's hit by number 88 with a ferocious tackle. It knocks Peters out of bounds. Uh-oh. Peters is stretched out with his teammates gathered around him. It may be that bad leg again. Looks like a bad break for them. Now the coach has decided to take him out, and Peters is limping off the field as a hush falls on the state rooters. Well, looks like the team will have to play with Peters out.
On the television show This Is Your Life, guests and relatives are usually flown in by a well-known airline. On one occasion, Lily Pons, the noted opera star, was the one whose life was being recreated. The master of ceremonies asked her mother if she had been flown in by the airline.
Oh, no, I don't like the aeroplane. It's not safe. I took the train.
We return you to the speaker's platform, where the audience is being addressed by Adlai Stevenson.
Protest demonstrations have taken place by workers whose trade union rights have been betrayed, by Catholics whose freedom of expression has been circumcised. By professional men. Well, I believe it at least is a Christian rite.
Let's listen to an introduction of famous news commentator John Cameron Swayze.
Stay tuned for John Solomon Quasi and the news.
All of society is expected to turn out for the charity ice show to be staged at our arena on February 3rd. One of our girls, Miss Lizzie Barker, will be competing in the figure-shaking championship.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce our cooking expert, who will tell you all about our new Betty Baker's Crock Mix. Betty Crocker's Bake Mix.
Good morning. Today we are going to bake a spice cake with special emphasis on how to flour your nuts.
Let's listen to this proud professor of music telling a radio audience about one of his pupils on a program that originated from a well-known college of music.
Our next number is Tchaikovsky's Violin Concerto, featuring our own violin virtuoso, Saul Tannenbaum. You will notice Mr. Tannenbaum plays passages of ease with the greatest of difficulty.
Play-by-play sports announcers sometimes get so carried away by the excitement of the moment that they forget that they are broadcasting on a live microphone to millions of people.
The bases are loaded. Count is 2 balls and 2 strikes on Wierowski. Here comes the pitch. It's a long fly deep to right field. Miller's fading back. Drops his sunglasses over his eyes, and the son of a bitch drops the ball with 3 on and 2 out.
A rock and roll disc jockey inadvertently picked up a recording left in his studio by a previous program which featured an hour of concert music. He picked up a recording of a Rachmaninoff piano concerto and gave it the following introduction.
Now, here's a record that features a selection by Rachmaninoff. Must be some new cat. Let's give it a listen, too.
We take you directly to a county fair in Arkansas.
While we're waiting for the main event to start, we might as well tell you about some other things that are happening down here, too. Now, Charlie Haybaker, he's from Hickory Grove, R.D., he has his nuts on display on a counter just down the aisle.
Ladies and gentlemen, the conclusion of Lightmare Theater. Ladies and gentlemen, the conclusion of Nightmare Theater featuring Frankenstein will not be seen due to the fact that our film department cannot locate the last reel of the movie. In its place, we'll show you the last half of a Shirley Temple picture, the title of which I do not know as yet.
Performers in radio and television have to start their careers somewhere. Mike fright is one of the beginner's biggest problems. Here's a case where a young lady had great difficulty in getting the words out on her first broadcast, which dealt with fashions.
And now for the latest from the fashion world. It is good news for men. Women are going to wear their dresses. Yeah. And now for the latest from... Yeah. And now for the latest from the fashion world. It is good news for men. Women are not going to wear their dresses any longer this year.
Lowell Thomas and the news. Lowell, have you a few more unforgettable words?
About a new book called Diet or Die. Author, Mrs. Celesta Geyer, perhaps better known to millions of carnival fans as the one-time Dolly Dimples. Remember, the world's most beautiful fat lady? That was the billing Mrs. Geyer used when she weighed 555 pounds. Count them, 555 pounds. Now a svelte 122. She tells in her book how she did it, following the advice of a doctor who told her after a near fatal heart attack to diet or die. The secret of effective weight loss, massive willpower, says Mrs. Geyer, adding that her own willpower was strengthened by the memory of... Well, anyhow, she said that her fat friends from carnival life died at an early age, later buried from the back of a truck. Those her own words. Why truck?
cousin, Mrs. Geyer, they were too big for a hearse.
And so long until Monday, Lowell. Listen each evening, Monday through Friday at this same time, for the distinctive news reports of Lowell Thomas.
Let's listen to an important public service message about the Salk polio vaccine.
Since the latest outbreak of this crippling disease, over 150,000 shots have been administered to children in 13 states. So remember, be sure to get your pork polio vaccine.
Bing Crosby, wrap your troubles and dreams, take four.
Castles may tumble, that's fate after all. Life's really funny that way. Sang the wrong melody, we'll play it back. See what it sounds like, hey, hey. He cut out 8 bars, the dirty bastard. And I didn't know which 8 bars he was gonna cut. Why don't somebody tell me these things around here? Holy Christ, I'm going off my nut.
Oh, you young men don't know what a thrill it is for me to be up here this afternoon addressing you. We want all you Cub Scouts to know that you should pick your own leader. Who can be like myself, either a male or female, or a combination of both?
For a limited time, you can take advantage of this brand new refrigerator trade-in offer and get a new self-defrosting refrigerator with all the latest features. Housewives, here's a chance to trade... I'm sorry.
What in the hell happened?
I'm sorry, my hand hit the mic. For a limited time, you can take advantage of this brand new refrigerator trade-in offer and get a new self-defrosting refrigerator with all the latest features. Housewives, here's a chance to trade in your old box for $150. Sounds like a great idea.
And so we conclude another in the Pardon My Blooper series of classic radio and television boners. Additional albums in this series will be released soon. Until we meet then, this is your narrator leaving you with the words of Alexander Pope, who said, "To err is human, to forgive, divine."